Were you scared? Estee comforts her scared cat, but it seems like Estee is preparing to do something. What's with all the things on the table? Oh, I know, I have a clue what she's trying to do. She's trying to demonstrate to her cat a volcanic eruption. I agree with the cat. Although everything is fascinating in a makeshift volcanic eruption, it wouldn't be so fun anymore if it happened in real life. Estee, you have to come inside now. There is a volcanic eruption. In today's episode of How to Survive, we will discuss what you should do to survive a volcanic eruption. Subscribe to the Science Times YouTube channel to watch our next episodes. A volcano, though beautiful as it looks from afar, can be hazardous once it decides to release molten rock, gases, and other debris. It can lead to disastrous events that can destroy properties and take people's lives. So it is imperative to know how to avoid letting it take away your life. You might find yourself gasping for air, getting blinded by smoke, and bleeding because of a burn when this happens, so you must prepare yourself and be vigilant at all times. First, listen to real-time news about the volcano eruption through your phone, television, or the radio. Remember to also bring your pets with you inside your house. Always keep your important documents in one envelope to easily grab it during immediate evacuations. Take out the emergency to-go bag that you prepared. It is important to always have it in case something like this happens. Your go bag should include three kinds of essentials. The first line of essentials refers to the things carried on your body for easy access. It should include a compass, whistle, map, GPS, and a multi-tool all tethered with a lanyard or to your clothes to avoid loss. Next is the second line of essentials carried and put inside a backpack. It should address your five basic needs: shelter, food, water, clothing, and a signaling kit. Lastly is the bare essentials. This is your first aid kit. It would be best to have a split bandage or gauze to prevent worsening and infection of an injury. But even if we are prepared, we cannot help but develop the nerves and panic when a volcano erupts. Just remember to keep calm and always move quickly. When an eruption occurs, you must prioritize your safety above all by staying alert and updated at all times. If lava flow is heading towards you, leave as early as possible. If you can drive, use your vehicle to move away from your area. If you are indoors, close all the openings to prevent the smoke and debris from the eruption from entering your home. But if you are outdoors, if you can, go inside a building immediately. If caught in a rockfall and cannot take shelter, duck, roll into a ball, and protect your head. Stay away from bodies of water as mudflow might happen. If possible, go to higher areas because they are considered safe zones when a volcano erupts. It can be as simple as a high-rise building. Do not use your vehicle and drive away, especially when the ashes from the eruption are already blinding your view because you might run into an accident. Remember that it is only safe to drive before a volcano eruption. But when all else has calmed down, you should not let your guard down and stay alert to stay safe. As much as possible, stay indoors and wait for local authorities to announce that it is safe to go outside. Alert other family and friends about your situation and ask for help. If you need to go outside, wear a mask and goggles to protect yourself from possible hazards left by the volcanic eruption. However, it is vital to remember that aftershocks could also happen after volcanic eruption. It can lead to further eruptions, floods, landslides, mudslides, and wildfires. A simple experiment like Estee did can teach us many things. It may not teach us all, but it creates awareness and the need to take specific measures to keep lives safe. Subscribe to Science Times for more survival tips like this. Also, remember to check out the other survive videos in the series. See you in the next episode.